of the thesis statement and its characteristics. So we have two tasks for today. The first task is reading the introductory part, as we already asked you to do. We are going to analyze it. We are going to have a critical reading on this introductory paragraph and explain every part of the introductory paragraph on this model until we move to thesis statement, and then we move to analyze this thesis statement, its structure, its characteristics, and so on and so forth. Okay? وأريد أن أنبهكم أنه المحاضرة المقبلة راح تكون امتحان شفهي. محاضرة المقبلة حتى من البداية لا أنسى راح تكون امتحان شفهي في البراكتس يعني الاكسرسايز براكتس 3 and براكتس 5 حل يعني الاكسرسايزز براكتس 3 on page 82 وبراكتس 5 on page 84. So let's start with our first task. We are going to read this paragraph, this introductory paragraph of this writing model. And we said that learning through models is an excellent way to acquire the good characteristics of writings. For example, if we want to learn how to write an introductory paragraph, we have to write, to read many introductory paragraphs. We have to analyze them. We have to acquire the best characteristics. If, for example, we want to learn how to write body paragraphs, we have also to read models of good body paragraphs, analyze them, see what characteristics are there in these good body paragraphs, how to start, how to develop, and how to end those body paragraphs, what kind of vocabularies we want to use, what ideas, how ideas are developed, and how those, you know, how ideas are related, yes, and developed in those paragraphs. For example, how they are cohesive and coherent and move to or give indication to other paragraphs or move to other paragraphs, okay, smoothly. So let's start with reading paragraph or the first paragraph of the model essay on page 75. Are you ready to read this paragraph?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. ممتاز. Let's make sharing first of all. The model paragraph, this one, okay. Jade. تشوفون الآن الشير دوكيمنت إن شاء الله الأمور واضحة ممتاز 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 let's register your names first okay today is 10:11 to 1 Yes, Hassan Kazem.
Yes, please. Good morning.
Good morning, Ahlan Hassan. Please read paragraph number one from the very beginning, from the very title of the essay.
You mean in the middle school, right?
Yes.
Yeah. The middle school years, grade 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are years when the different rates of girls and boys, physical emotion and cognitive development are the most noticeable girls develop ahead of boys every area and both suffer educator of debate, whether suppression of boys and girls into single-sex classes might improve students' academic performance.
Thank you very much, Hassan. Good, Hassan. Thank you. Quickly, Hassan Khalil, continue,
yes.
Please.
Yes, thanks. Yes. Single-sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago. But now they have become more common owner and Hollingsworth. Also, some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups continue to oppose single-sex classes. There is some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle school reduce positive result.
Okay, thank you very much. Just, we are going to focus on this lesson. We are going to focus on the introductory paragraph, this introductory paragraph only, okay? We are going to read it, analyze it, and then see what characteristics are there in this introductory paragraph. Okay, Zahra Muhammad.
No.
Yes, please go ahead reading from the very beginning.
The middle school years, grade 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are the years when the different traits of girls and boys, physical, emotional, and cognitive development are most noticeable. Girls develop ahead of boys in every area. And both suffer educator depart whether
زهراء بس انتبهي لي شوي زهراء عندما نقرا ونوصل الى فول ستوب يجب علينا ان نقف يعني فول ستوب يعني to stop fully we have to stop here we have to stop fully and then move to the next sentence to give indications to the reader who is to give indication to our listeners okay who are listening to us that we finished the previous sentence and moved to the next sentence. So we have to say like this, in every area and both suffer. We stop a little bit and both suffer. Educators debate whether, okay, then we read the next sentence. So please, again, read the previous one and stop and then start with educators.
Girls developed ahead of boys in every area and both suffer.
Excellent.
Educator debate whether the separating of boys and girls into single-sex classes may improve students' academic performance.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Zahra. Thank you very much. Arwa Imad, go ahead. Okay. Amani Adbi.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Single-sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago, but now they have become more common. Bonner and Hollingsworth. Although some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups continue to oppose single-sex classes, there is some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle school produce positive results.
Excellent. Good. Ibrahim Rafa.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, please. Go ahead.
The middle school years, grades 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are the years when the different grades of girls and boys' physical, emotional, and cognitive development are most noticeable. Girls develop ahead of boys in every area, and both suffer. Educators debate where the separation of boys and girls into single-sex classes might improve students' academic performance.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Tabarak Shihab.
Madam Doctor.
Yes, please.
Single-sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago, but now they have become more common. Bonner and Hollingsworth.
Okay.
Also, some parents, educators, and civil liberties group continue to offer single sex classes. There is some advance that separating boys and girls in middle school produce positive results.
Yes, thank you. Ahmed Abdul Abbas.
No, I'm sorry.
Yes, please.
Middle school years, grades 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are the years when the different rate of girls and boys' physical, emotion, and cognitive development are most noticeable. Girls develop ahead of boys in every area, and both suffer. Educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into sex, single-sex class might improve students' academic. Singular classes were against the law in public
schools. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Ayat Salah. نعم.
بس هسه صحت باسمي المايك شكل ما فتح وانا كنت اقرا مستمرة فاجئت تحت الاماني.
اوكي اروع عماد.
نعم دكتور.
اوكي تقرين بعد ايات صلاح. نعم ايات صلاح.
Signal 6 classes were against the law in public school until
several... Ayat, just listen to me. It is not signal, it is single.
Yes,
Okay, no worries.
Single-sex classes were against the law in public school until several years ago. But now they have become more common. Bonner and Hollingsworth. Okay. Also, some parents, educators, and several liberties groups continue to abuse single-sex classes. There is some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle school produce positive results.
Thank you very much, Ayat. Thank you. Gilna Arwa, yes, please.
Yes, Victor.
Yeah.
Separating the six just for the tough years. The middle school years, grades 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. There are the years when the different rates of girls and boys, physical, emotional, and cognitive development are more noticeable. Girls developed ahead of boys in every area and both suffer. Educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single-sex class might improve students' academic performance.
Thank you very much, Arwa. Thank you. Yes, Haider Amr.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please, go ahead.
Yes. Single-sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago, but now they have become more common, Bonner and Hollingsworth. Although some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups continue to oppose single-sex classes, there are some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle schools produce positive results.
Thank you very much, Haider. Finally, Benin Hamid.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, please.
The middle school years, grades 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are the years when the different rates of girls and boys.
When different rates of girls and boys,
physical, emotional, and cognitive development are most not noticeable. Girls develop ahead of boys and in every area. And both suffer. Educator debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single-sex classes might improve student academic performance.
Thank you very much. Aya Ahmed. Aya Ahmed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please, go ahead.
So writing the six is just for the tough years. The middle school years, grades 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are the years when the different rates for girls
and when I Ahmed, go ahead, يعني proceed. Don't start from the very beginning. ما يخاذا ما عرفتي تسألين قولي وين وصلت. وصلنا للنص يعني من مدينة لحد الآن الجزء الأول ينتهي إلى performance وأسأل الطالب الثاني يبدأ ب single sex classes were against the law.
أوكي.
إذا كنت ما متابع الموضوع فأقري لي from the second part of this paragraph single sex classes were against. Yes please.
Single sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago, but now they have become more common. Bonner and Hollingworth, also some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups continue to be opposite single-sex classes. There is some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle school produce positive results.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, students. Now we are going to, I'm going to read this paragraph and then analyze it sentence by sentence. Please, students, we are going to analyze this, but this is not, this is not necessarily the perfect model we are going to imitate while writing. When we are trying to write an introductory paragraph, we are not going to write exactly the same quality as this introductory paragraph is. But we are going to learn from this introductory paragraph many points how to develop our ideas until we reach the thesis statement. First, I'm going to read it, and then we are going to analyze it sentence by sentence. Separating the sexes just for the tough years. Listen to me, please. Separating the sexes, comma, just for the tough years. The middle school years, grades 6, 7, and 8, are known to be the tough years. These are the years when the different rates of girls and boys' physical, emotional, and cognitive development are most noticeable. Girls develop ahead of boys in every area, and both suffer. Educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single-sex classes might improve students' academic performance. Single-sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago, but now they have become more common. Bonner and Hollingsworth. Although some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups continue to oppose single-sex classes, there is some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle school produces positive results. So here we have the title of the model essay. The title of the model essay, who can tell me what does the title here tell us? What does the title here tell us? Okay. Ayat Salah?
Yes, doctor.
Yes, please.
English.
لا بالإنجليزي.
When we separating boys and girls, we will have a more improved result because this year, that's called the tough years, it's more hard on the both girls and boys. For that reason, when we separating them, we will might have a positive result because
Ayat. Ayat. Yani, I asked you about the title. I asked you about the title. Yani, suppose that there is no, there is no. لا 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 آيات. تي ما فهمتي السؤال مالتي. سؤال مالتي ما فهمتي. What does the title tell us? What does the title tell us here? This is the question. You explained another point. You explained something else, something different. I'm going to ask you about these things, but now my question is, what does the title tell us? Separating the sexes just for the toughies. Okay. خلي نشوف. Thank you very much, Ayat Salah. خلي نشوف حسن كاظم.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, please. What does the title tell us?
I think, in my opinion, it's the problem for against us in the schools 6 and 7 and 8 for the students and physical sex.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Hassan. Hassan Kazem. Okay. Ayat Salah and Hassan Kazem. Ahmed Abdul Abbas. What does the title tell us?
It's obviously tell us about separating the two sexes, girls and boys, in the school and of course in the middle grades like 6, 8, 7.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ahmed Abdul Abbas. Haider Amr.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
I think it's telling us what will happen if we separate the sexes in just the tough years.
Do you think that the title, this title, for example, as I said to Ayat, suppose that we have no essay. We have no essay. We don't know. We didn't read the introductory paragraph. We didn't read anything about the essay. Just we read the title of the essay. What does the title tell you?
It raises the question in my head, what will happen if we separate the sexes?
Okay, separating the sexes? Yes. Just for the toughies. Okay, thank you very much. Amani Azbi.
Yes, sir. The title gives us like a general idea, like what the essay is going to be about. What am I going to read? That's what the title is for.
Okay, thank you very much. Neely, ما ادري طلاب انتم رافعين ايدكم للجواب لو يعني still raising your hands for reading. اوكي ممتاز. لان من اسال يعني انا جاي اختار من القائمه اللي الطلاب اللي رافعين ايدهم. ربا حسام.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
I think it tell about mixing and the problem it cues, especially the problem that happens between boy and girls in the age of teenagers.
Okay, thank you very much. Tabarak Shihab.
Yes. The topic is about teenager students when they start their teenager breeding, maybe they affect by the simple things.
اوكي.
Yeah.
تبارك منو قبلك جاوبني؟
ربا حسام.
اوكي ربا حسام حتى اسجل اسمها. اوكي. ممتاز. طلاب يعني the reason why I ask this question is just to tell you something. When we read the title without reading the whole essay, the title is supposed to tell us something very simple. It is not complicated. Something very simple. What is the topic of the essay? That's it. Still, we are not reading the... Yeah, suppose, as I said to you, suppose that we didn't read the essay. What does the title tell us? The title tells us about the topic, the general topic of the essay. So, what is the general topic of the essay? The general topic of the essay is separating the sexes just for the toughies. This is the topic we are going to talk about. But sometimes as one of the students say something related to this, it raises some, it stimulates something in us. It stimulates us to know what is going to happen about what is going to happen in the essay. So first of all, it tells us about the topic in general. It talks about separating the sexes. In general, we don't know anything about the essay. Before reading the essay, we don't know what about separating the sexes. Is he or she going to, for example, support it or disagree with this idea? This is one point. Second, so here we have two branches of the topic, two branches of the title. Separating the sexes, comma, just for the toughies. So separating the sexes, separating the genders, separating males and females in, at a certain stage. Yes, at a certain stage. And then the title tells us something very general about the topic. That's it. This is the answer. It tells us about the topic of the essay, the topic we are going to tackle, discuss, argue. We don't know until we read the first paragraph. We don't know the opinion of the writer, whether he disagrees, agrees, argues, make comparison, contrast. For example, produce or presents a problem solution for something. We don't know. So simply speaking, the title tells us about the topic in general. What is the topic of the whole essay? That's it. إذن عندما نقرأ التايتل نقرأ عنوان الأسي. Title ما راح ينطينا معلومة, any specific information. The title will never tell us a specific information about the core idea of what the core idea or the opinion of the writer. We know the core idea, the opinion of the writer, when we read the introductory paragraph. So this how the title should be. صار واضح الآن؟ أكو سؤال لحد الآن؟ Any question, please? Now, we move from something very general about the topic, which is represented, given by the title. We move to ask ourselves, what does the writer want to tell us about this general topic? Separating the sexes. Yes, separating means what? Means putting away, setting away the genders, putting or separating females and males, separating them where and when. Okay, يعني هو يتكلم عن فصل الجندرز, the males and the females, لكن not in a very wide sense of the term. هو حددها هنا اكو نوع من التحديد. Separating the sexes just for the toughies. إذن هذا هو أول ما بدأ بالgeneral topic, separating the sexes. بعدين أعطانا a more specific information about what? About separating the sexes at which stage? Toughies. طبعا إذا ما نعرف التوفيز نروح مثلا نشيك يعني what is the tough, what is meant by the toughies, why it is called toughies, we don't know. Because it is very general, from the very topic, from the very title, sorry, of the essay, it is very general. We don't know any idea about, we don't know any viewpoint about the topic. لحد الآن احنا ما نعرف شنو اللي راح يصير. زين. إذا راح ننتقل الآن من مرحلة العموميات إلى مرحلة شرح هذا المفهوم. فيبدأ بـ sentence number one. Sentence number one, the middle school years, grade 6, 7 and 8 are known to be the tough years. هنا الكاتب شنو سوى؟ The writer. What does the writer do here? Haider Amr.
He clarified to us what does it mean, what is tough years? What are the tough years?
Excellent, that's it. Simply speaking, he directly starts, he or she, the writer, directly starts with explaining to us this term, tough years. Why? لماذا? طلاب, لماذا the writer starts by this general statement? Haider Amr.
To remove the fogginess from the title, he's gonna slowly make the title less vague and move through the whole paragraph and make basically this paragraph will tell us everything about the title.
Okay, thank you very much. Zainab Mu'ayyad.
Yes, so it's like establish something for the title, because we say tough years, so he needs to explain that before we move to the next sentence. Before we move to more specific information, we need to identify tough years.
Excellent. Excellent. We need, as readers, we need to know what is meant by tough years. So he directly starts, he or she directly starts with explaining to us what is meant by tough years. So first of all, the writer directly establishes, as Zainab said, establishes or identifies what is meant by tough years, to move then step by step explaining the ideas about this title. So first of all, he explains the meaning of tough years. Thank you very much. So this is a good answer, identifying, establishing, explaining what is meant by tough years said or mentioned in the title. إذن هنا في هذه الحالة طلاب في هذه الحالة الكاتب هنا انتقل من something very wide, the topic, into something also wider, but it is what? It is narrower, okay? It is something narrower. صحيح هو wide, لكن narrower than the topic or the title of the essay. أنا ما أريد أعقد عليكم المسألة, لكن هذا الشرح راح نشرحه maybe for this essay as a model. لكن هذا الشرح يبقى في بالك, خلي من تقرأ شنو من تقرأ essay. يعني whenever you read an essay, خلي هذا الشرح في بالك. أول ما نقرأ التايتل, هذا التايتل يخبرنا بشيء very wide about the whole essay. It tells us about the topic, generally speaking. We don't know any viewpoint about the topic. أول جملة يبدأ بها الـ introductory paragraph هو explaining something about the topic, but not yet explained well. We need other description, other explanation to deconstruct, يعني نفكك ال what will happen, what is the viewpoint of the writer about the topic. So the first sentence is very general too. ننتقل إلى second sentence. طلاب, what happens in the second sentence? What does the writer tell us in the second sentence? بعد طلاب, good. بعد, ممتاز. Z زهراء حميد سلطان.
Yes, doctor.
More yes, please. Yes.
More explain about tough years.
More explanation about tough years. Excellent. Excellent. ممتاز. يعني what does this mean? More explanation about tough years. Hassan Kazem.
Yes, the problem in this age, it's what tell us about the physical and emotional single sex classes, boys and girls.
Okay. Good.
I think that's in my opinion, of course.
Okay. Thank you very much, Hassan. جيد. حيدا عامر.
Yes, sir. The second sentence is basically the supporting sentence of our topic sentence, which establishes what tough years are. So it's going now to further explain what are tough years.
Okay, excellent. Further explanation about the first sentence. Yeah. So can you see how the writer is moving from very wide background into narrowing it down. يعني جاي ينتقل الكاتب بالضبط. Like a funnel, excellent. Like a funnel, yes, funnel introduction. يعني ينتقل من something very wide إلى something very specific. وكأنما إحنا جاي نباوح إلى الفانل فيجر. الفانل اللي شرحناه بالأسبوع الماضي. يبدأ من شيء very wide at the top, moving into the very specific what. يعني احنا صحيح جاي نباوع. شوف هسه شنو انا اريد من عندك؟ اريد من عندك تباوع لهذا الباراجراف اللي هو in front of us. وكأنما شكله مو هذا المستطيل. جاي يعني تفهمون شنو اقصد؟ يعني هذه الجمل اللي كتبت اوكي يعني خلي اشر على الباراجراف حتى تفهمون بالضبط شنو انا جاي اقصد. اوكي انتبه لي شويه طلاب. شنو اللي جاي اقصده هسه حاليا من يعني من الشرح from the very beginning until this point؟ ومثل ما قالوا الطلاب ايات صلاح يعني عند الشيء تقولي اوكي تبيني شويه طلاب. احنا جاي نبدا وكانما هسه عوف التايتل. هذا التايتل خلي نعوفه لانه التايتل يخبرنا عن التوبيك in its widest sense يعني specifically يعني بالتحديد يخبرنا عن التوبيك in its widest sense يعني في اوسع شيء أو في أوسع ما يوحي له التوبيك، ما يوحي له الموضوع اللي نتكلم عنه. أريدك من تنظر إلى الباراجراف بالفانل، الفانل تايب أوف إنتروداكت باراجراف، تنظر له بهذه الهيئة. بس انتبه لي شوية ويعني I hope that I will do it very well. ممتاز. جاي يشوفون الآن؟
yes. Yes.
جاي يشوفون هذا الشكل.
yes.
أريدك تنظر له بهذه الهيئة. يعني هذا الباراجراف صحيح هو عبارة عن sentences written one after another in this in this form. يعني like what like a yes like what like a rectangular form. يعني الشيب الأول هو مستطيل لكن هو حقيقة الأمر ب يعني في الحركة حركة الجمل أو حركة الأفكار هي بهذا الشكل تريانجل، يعني حركة الأفكار من الأفكار الواسعة إلى الأفكار ال very or the most specific one, the most specific ideas. يعني انتقل من شيء جدا واسع مثل ما قرأنا بالجملة الأولى. The middle school years, grade 6, 7, 8 are known to be the tough years. First of all, he tells us or identifies to us what is meant by tough years. Tough years is the same as the middle school years. يعني he meant by the tough years the middle school years specifically, مو أي middle school years. لا, هو the transitional stage or transitional or the transition from the primary to secondary schools. يعني هذه النقلة من ال يعني the end of the primary school اللي هي six grade six where the start of the secondary school اللي هي 7 and 8. يعني مرحلة الانتقال هذا العمر specifically للأولاد والبنات يسمونه تفيز اللي هو ياه middle school is not in general. لا, أنا هو حددها between two brackets, قال grades 6, 7 and 8. هذه الجملة الأولى. بعدين أعطانا further explanation about this tough years. زين, يقدر واحد يجاوبني الجملة الثانية؟ طبعا جاوبني أحد الطلبة أعتقد, يعني جاوبني قال لي more or further explanation, لكن ممكن واحد يجاوبني الجملة الثانية شنو أنطت للقارئ؟ صحيح, further explanation, further explanation, لكن بالتحديد what kind of further explanation. زينب مؤيد,
let's explain why these are the tough years.
Excellent. Excellent, Zainab. Gives us what even? Gives us explanation or gives us the reason why these years are considered as tough years. So, justification for sentence number one. Explanation for sentence number one. Giving reasons for sentence number one. So, moving from wider into more specific, into a narrower. Moving from something we ask about. So, why these are called tough years. We knew from the very beginning of this paragraph that this sentence or the starting sentence of this introductory paragraph tells us something about tough years, but it doesn't tell us why they are called tough years. Then بالجملة الأولى identifies, explains or tells us or describes something about the tough years. Tells us, identifies the toughies by giving what? By giving a replacement, by giving a substitution. يعني شيء بديل حتى يفهمنا. هذه toughies middle school years, grade 6, 7, 8. لكن in the first sentence, he doesn't tell us why they are considered as toughies. هنا راح يعني ننتقل من الأوسع إلى الأضيق. من المفهوم الواسع إلى المفهوم الأضيق قليلا. These are the years when the different traits of girls and boys, physical, emotional and cognitive development are most noticeable. So here is why they are called tough years. Because there are changes. There are modifications. There are developments specifically. In what developments? Developments in the physical and related to body. Developments in emotional related to feelings. And also developments in cognitive related to mentality of boys and girls. So boys and girls at this particular stage, we called middle school years 6, 7, 8, or let's call it tough years. There are certain changes related to body, to their bodies, related to their feelings, related to their mentality and reasoning things. إذن في الجملة الثانية توضحت المسألة أكثر. جاي تلاحظون هذا الشيء طلاب؟
Yes, sir.
ممتاز ممتاز excellent. الآن نجي إلى more specifications, يعني نجي إلى تحديد أكثر في الجملة الثالثة. Girls develop ahead of boys. طبعا girls develop ahead of boys, هنا شو تكلم؟ شوف هنا اتكلم عن مفهوم development, لأنه احنا قلنا في الجملة الثانية قلنا development في الجملة الثانية قلنا development. حتى يشرح هذا development قال girls develop. شوف هنا إذا نكرر بعض الكلمات, شوف بالwriting أولا there are certain شو نسميها يعني there are certain repetitions. أوكي يعني هنا عندنا بعض التكرار, لكن التكرار مو التكرار الغير النافع. أكو نوع من التكرار في كتابتنا يكون نافع جدا. ماذا يفيد التكرار النافع؟ يعني can you explain can you tell me مثلا التكرار النافع شنو فائدته؟ يعني what does good repetitions help us in مثلا حيدر؟
Just like now, sir, the repetition was meant to answer a specific point, a specific question that was raised.
Okay, good. Yeah. Okay. Something else, Zahra Hamid?
Made the idea clear.
Make the idea clear. Excellent. Also, good. What else, Ruba Hussam?
To confirm the information.
Sorry?
To confirm the information.
To confirm. Also good. Good answer. Bad. Confirming some information. Making ideas clearer. develop our ideas. لكن ال main function هو creating what? Creating the unity. يعني خلي ال نسق ال ideas united, يعني يوحد المفهوم ويسوي repetition حتى يعني يضيف coherence إلى الكتابة مالتك. يعني to make the paragraph more cohesive and coherent at the same time, يعني مترابط بشكل ممتاز, مترابط من حيث التكست, يعني من حيث مترابط يعني الأفكار مترابطة and moving smoothly from one sentence into another, وكذلك مترابطة من حيث moving not only moving the sentences from one to another, يعني وكأنما هو جاي يربط الجملة اللاحقة بالجملة السابقة من خلال بعض repetition. يعني هنا قلنا development وهنا قلنا girls develop ahead of boys in every area and both suffer. فربطنا الجملة اللاحقة بالجملة السابقة من خلال استخدام another part of speech. يعني احنا قلنا parts of speech, هنا مثلا استخدمنا development. Which part of speech is development? Which part of speech? طلاب تعرفون شنو معنى parts of speech؟
Yes, sir. It's a
name. Excellent. Noun, yes. يعني في parts of a speech, for example, we have nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, etc. Okay? فهنا في الجملة الثانية استخدمنا development. بالجملة اللاحقة الثالثة استخدم develop. يعني بالجملة الثانية استخدم noun. بالجملة الثالثة استخدم verb. وهذا الاستخدام وهذا الrepetition وهذا الاستخدام الجيد للparts of speech وmoving from for example verifying the uses or the parts of speech from verbs into nouns into adjectives etc. هذا يضيف ماذا؟ يضيف تنوع في الكتابة حتى لا يمل القارئ من نفس الاستخدام المتكرر. هو التكرار قد يكون جدا مضر بالكتابة, لكن أكو تكرار نافع. تكرار نافع مثلا تكرار لبعض الايديز الكي بوينتس. This is my point. This is my point. التكرار يخلينا نستفيد من نستفيد ونركز يعني focus our attention on key ideas, key points. هذا الغاية المفيدة من التكرار وهو it helps us what it helps us focus on the key ideas, key words, key ideas. يعني الأفكار المفاتيح يسموها الأفكار أو الكلمات المفاتيح اللي من خلالها تكون الكتابة مالتنا coherent and cohesive at the same time. إذن الجملة الثالثة انتقل مو من الجملة الأولى لا طورنا الجملة الثانية قال girls develop ahead of boys in every area. طبعا هنا every area every area what does this refer to. شوف شلون الجمل مترابطة الجملة الثالثة مترابطة بالجملة الثانية الجملة الثانية مترابطة بالجملة الأولى إذن هي عملية شنو هي عملية تحرك مدروس من جملة إلى جملة وكل جملة لاحقة تشرح الجملة السابقة طلاب حيدر عامر نعم
Yes, sir. The every area he meant, the areas he mentioned above, physically, emotionally, cognitively.
Excellent. Excellent, Haider. هنا الكاتب شوف جاي يشرح جملة بجملة. يعني كل جملة يسوقها إلنا يشرحها بالجملة اللاحقة. لكن differently. ما يستخدم نفس العبارات. لا. يستخدم other placements. Other variations, other substitutions. بدل ما يقول physical, emotional, cognitive, قال in every area. بس ضاف لنا جملة. شوف كل جملة جديدة يجب أن تضيف معنى جديد. كل جملة جديدة تضيف معنى جديد. هي توضح المعنى السابق وتضيف معنى جديد. والجملة الأخرى توضح المعنى السابق وتضيف معنى جديد توضح وهكذا حتى يعني تكون الكتابة مالتنا مفهومة جدا للقارئ القارئ ما يتعب قارئ ما يتعب يعرف الكنكشن يعرف الكنكشن between these sentences one explaining the other every sentence explains the previous one and adds something new and the following sentence does the same Adding something new, explaining something previous. Adding something new, explaining something previous. And this way, we will help our readers understand what we mean by our writing. زين ننتقل إلى الشيء الجديد and both suffer. هذه جملة صحيح. هي خرجت من رحم الجمل السابقة لكنها جديدة. هنا أنا راح نقول they both suffer. Why? Do they suffer? Why do they suffer? So both girls and boys develop physically, emotionally, and cognitively, but they suffer at this particular what? At this particular stage, at the tough years, at the transitional stage, moving from primary school into the secondary school. فيجي هنا يقول بالجملة الرابعة. Educators debate. Now we're going to talk about the argument, the debate, the discussion, مثلاً. Okay? Educators, طبعاً, what is meant by educators? Educators are those working at the educational institution. مثلاً, teachers, specifically here, it is meant by, يعني, it means, sorry, it is mean. Sorry, it is meant by, oh, عفوا أنا تعبت, لكن, it means what? It means those teachers, okay, who are working at the education institution. Okay, the educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single sex classes might improve students' academic performance. تقدر تشرح لي شنو صار بهاي الجملة؟ من يشرح لي شنو صار بهاي الجملة؟ بعد طلاب فكر بيها فكر بيها Educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single sex classes might improve students' academic performance. طبعا احنا رحنا زايد بالتحليل لكن لا بأس. هذا التحليل طلاب يعني قد بعض الطلاب يقولون ماكو داعي مثلا لهذا التحليل العميق، لكن هذا التحليل نافع. عندما تقرأ أي شيء وتنظر لهذه النظرة راح يصير عندك نظرة مختلفة، راح يصير دراستك مختلفة، راح يصير فهمك للأشياء مختلف. طبعا أنا ما كنت يعني ناوي أدخل بهذه التفاصيل، لكن وجدت نفسي هكذا يعني دخلنا بتفاصيل عميقة جدا. أحمد عبد العباس.
Yes sir.
Yes please.
Just obviously that's teachers and anyone in generally in charge, they're just discussing about the problem of that happens the
girls and concerning the improvement of the boys and girls, and of course some of them might agree and some of them might disagree.
Excellent, good. Ayat Salah.
Sorry, Ayat Salah.
آيات صالح. أوكي آيات صالح.
آيات صالح هما.
ممتاز. جيد. Good. آيات صالح. Yes please. وشكرا للتوضيح.
Yeah. Thank you. He explained what if we separation of about boys and girls and to single sex classes. What will when they grow up, what will they do? What about okay. physical or anything else?
Okay, Ayat Saleh. طبعاً the benefit of knowing the function of the parts of speech. يعني وظيفة أقسام الكلام هنا. يعني when to use the verb, when to use the noun, and when to use when and how to use the adjective. طبعا من قلنا we separation ما يصير. We separation لازم نقول we separate. لأنه parts of speech إذا تلاحظ هنا الجملة الثانية مثلا بها مثلا كلمة لو فرضنا كلمة different. Now different which part of speech؟ كلمة different which part of speech is زينب مؤيد؟ يا طلاب in general which part of speech different?
It's a noun here. It's a noun.
No, different is not a noun here. Haider.
Adjective.
It's adjective. Why?
Describe something. It's adjective.
Describes what?
The rates. So it's describing.
Excellent. Excellent, Haider. So it is adjective different. Because it describes what? It qualifies and describes a noun. It is followed by a noun. Different rates. Different rates. Then, what is the noun from different?
Difference.
Difference. Excellent. Difference. ممتاز. إذا لازم نعرف ال parts of speech حتى نعرف نستخدمها في الكتابة. يعني هي الكتابة ليش قلنا الكتابة شيء يعني أصعب من بقية ال skills. لأنه الكتابة تحتم علينا معرفة الأمور اللي تتعلق بالنحو. الكتابة تحتم علينا نعرف more vocabulary items. الكتابة تحتم علينا معرفة a wide range of vocabulary items, variety of vocabulary items. شلون نسوي هال variation؟ شلون نسوي هذه extension of vocabulary items؟ نسويها من خلال what؟ نسويها من خلال our knowledge of parts of speech. يعني أنا إذا أعرف different لازم أعرف difference. أوكي okay. إذا أعرف مثلا development لازم أعرف develop. إذا أعرف improve لازم أعرف النون من عندها improvement. وإذا عرفت إذا عرفت الimprove أستخدمها كفعل واستخدام آخر يفيدني. يعني هذه الكلمة معرفتها استخدام آخر بدل ما أستخدمها فعل أستخدمها نون أستخدمها improvement. بدل ما اعرف يعني بدل ما اعرف فقط development او notice the word notice which part of speech here noticeable
noticeable is a noun
noticeable is a noun
Noticeable difference. No, no, it's an adjective.
It's an adjective. Yes, adjective. Noticeable is an adjective. Notice could be a noun, and notice could be a verb. When we say, for example, please refer to the notice mentioned below. مثلا اقول لك انا please refer to the notice mentioned below يعني انتبه للملاحظه اللي مسجله في الاسفل مثلا او اقول لك please notice the following for example sentence please notice that something هنا تستخدم كشنو كverb اذا اكو كلمات تستخدم هي نفسها تستخدم verb وهي نفسها تستخدم تستخدم noun من اللي يحدد هذا الشيء هو الكونتكست الجملة السياق استخدامها اوكي فمعرفة parts of speech very necessary for you for us as English language learners for us as users of the language حتى في اللغة العربية احنا يعني استخدمها وإن كان استخدام لأنه احنا اللغة العربية هي our mother tongue فنستخدمها بشكل صحيح ما نقول مثلا احنا استخدام بشكل صحيح نقول احنا نستخدمه بشكل صحيح بينما يجب علينا استخدام المفردات بشكل صحيح شوف كلمة نستخدم وكلمة استخدام اوكي فالparts of speech جدا ضروري معرفتها development هي سوي عندنا extension of our vocabulary items noticeable من notice different difference development من develop develop من development وهكذا بعد ذلك مثلا شنو عندنا الكلمات مثلا كلمة performance مثلا academic و academy or the academy هي تصير بعد اذا قلنا academy و academic اذا صارت شنو اذا صارت adjective شوف academic هنا صارت adjective بينما النون من عنده academy زين مثلا عندنا separation which part of speech
it's a noun
name
no, excellent no. ما نقول name لا نقول noun parts of speech هو noun okay. Okay. زين الverb من separation
separate
excellent زين شنو adjective من separation
separate
excellent separate يعني the same as the verb the same as the verb
different pronunciation
excellent different pronunciation excellent different pronunciation يعني separate when it is verb separate when it is what when it is a yes adjective مثلا advocate معناها support advocate when it is what when it is a verb an advocate a noun an advocate of something يعني supporter of something اذا معرفتنا بالparts of speech جدا ضروريه وتخدمنا في الكتابه والقراءه at the same time يعني our read comprehension and our writing for what for variation يعني للتنوع معرفه الparts of speech تخدمنا في التنوع تنوع الاستخدام الان educators Educators, which part of speech?
It's a noun.
A noun. What is the difference between educator, which is a noun, and education, which is also a noun?
Education is not a person.
Excellent. Education refers to the process of education in general. But educators refer to what? To persons. يعني teachers. Okay? You know, those people who are interested in not interested who are working at the educational شوف هنا استخدمنا شنو قلنا at the educational شنو حولنا كلمة education إلى شنو
adjective
yes,
excellent حولناها من education شوف الكلام شلون يعني يصير بتنوع إذا استخدمنا وعرفنا the parts of speech إذا الغاية من هذا الكلام هو أنه عندما تقرأ وتبحث عن معاني الكلمات لا تبحث عن المعنى فقط First of all you have to check and know and practice its pronunciation You have to know the transcription mentioned in the dictionary The transcription Okay? First of all, you have to understand and know how the word pronounces. How can you pronounce the word? Okay? So practice pronunciation. بعد ذلك اعرف المينينج. ممكن تعرف المينينج ان another using what? Using binary dictionary, يعني using Arabic, using English Arabic, or I recommend using English English. You know the pronunciation through the transcription, you know its meaning using different words. When the dictionary explains the meaning of a word differently, using other words, different words to explain the meaning of the word. And also you know the uses, يعني how it is used in different contexts. مثلا educators, يعني how educators is used. The dictionary will give you what? Will give you examples. How education, so we moved from educators as a noun referring to people into education as a noun referring to the referring to the process of education. بعد ذلك ينطيك شنو educational, ينطيك الadjective.
And there's the verb which is educate.
Excellent. And the verb is educate. إذا معرفتنا إذا أروح أشيك أنا الeducator. ما شيكت فقط الeducator, شيكت أربع أشياء أو أكثر أو أقل من خلال هذا التشيك, من خلال هذه يعني this way of studying, this way of analysis. طبعا شنو قلت أنا this way of analysis, أقدر أقول this way of analyzing something, حولتها من noun إلى verb باستخدام ال ing. هنا استخدم يعني حولتها الى يسمونه gerund بالجرامر او الparticipal, sorry الparticipal not the gerund, الparticipal. اوكي بالجرامر يسموه participle, يعني هذا يعني شرحه في يعني عندما نضيف الاي ان جي ونحول من مفهوم ال مرات ما نستخدم الاوكسيليير فيرب. اوكي في certain context, مثلا انا قلت of analyzing, انا استخدمت preposition وهذا شرحها المهم يعني ادخل زايد في بعض الامور اللي تتعلق بالجرامر. زين فمن خلال هذه الطريقه في الدراسه راح تتعرف على هواي كلمات. شوف هسه احنا فقط يعني استخدمنا كم كلمه تعرفنا عليها كثير. زين separation, separate, separate, separation of boys and girls into single class, yes, single sex classes might improve students' academic performance. مثلا which part of speech is performance?
It's a name. No.
Excellent. زين. How to change it into or what is the verb from performance?
Perform.
Excellent. Excellent. Perform. And then, from the very beginning of this introductory paragraph, the writer starts with a general background about the topic. He identifies the meaning of tough years in the first sentence. Then he explains why these are the tough years by telling us that there are different different rates of modifications of change in physical, emotional and cognitive. There are developments in these areas, and these developments are what are noticeable, are observable. Yani we can observe them easily. Yani we have experience in observing these changes, these developments. بعد ذلك moves to the following sentence. Girls develop ahead of boys. شنو ahead of boys, يعني what does he mean by ahead of boys?
More than boys.
Hinana.
Faster than boys.
Before the boys.
Excellent. Before. Earlier. Okay. Earlier than boys. يعني هنا الgirls هذه development حسب طبعا حسب رأي الكاتب هنا يعني هسه علميا هو هنا ما شاير إلى مصدر ولكن قد يعتبرها فد common sense. مرات المعلومة إذا اعتبرناها common ماكو داعي نشير إلى مثلا إذا نقول education is important صحيح هذا opinion لكن يعني وكأنما متفق عليه education is important okay صحيح هو opinion لأنه هنا استخدمنا adjective لكن ماكو داعي أنا هنا أذكر مصدر لأنه it is common among all of us all people they agree that education is important okay so there's no need to what to refer to a يعني a reference okay مصدر يعني لي مثل ما سوى بالجمل الأخرى هسه راح إن شاء الله نقراها okay عندنا وقت إن شاء الله نكمل الباراجراف مو طبعا بعدنا بالجزء الأول حتى ننتقل إلى الجزء الثاني أو نكتفي إن شاء الله فد ربع ساعة نكتفي إن شاء الله انتبهوا لي طلاب إذن قال girls develop ahead of boys يعني earlier than boys before boys and girl sorry in every area يعني in those areas physical emotional and cognitive development and both suffer but both suffer طبعا احنا نعرف هذا الشيء يعني by experience and by يعني naturally يعني by our experience in our life that girls develop before boys okay in these areas but at this particular stage at this particular age لحظة اوكي ممتاز good عندنا مجال ان شاء الله at this particular age okay both suffer why suffer because of these changes of these developments sorry زين او changes ما يخالف مقبولة هسه راح وكأنما يعني تحرك الكاتب هنا من يعني تحرك او وصل الى الى هذه المرحلة يعني من ال narrowing down the ideas narrowing down the ideas يعني راح يدخل بلب الموضوع the writer will be so specific about يعني will be يعني more specific about the topic educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single sex classes might improve students academic performance المعلومة الجديدة شنو هنا أنا في هذه الجملة أولا we have what we have a debate we have an argument among whom among educators whether separating boys from girls or separating boys and girls at this particular age in a school at this middle school years 6, 7, and 8 will affect their academic performance or not يعني هل separating them إذن انتقلنا إلى شنو انتقلنا إلى إعطاء الرأي طلاب انتبهوا لي شوي هاي نقطة مهمة جدا انتقلنا من الشرح المعنى التفييز إلى السبب اللي من أجله قلنا أن this particular age or this particular years are tough years difficult why انتقلنا إلى الآن راح يذكر راح يذكر لب المشكلة وينطي الرأي مالته ينطي الرأي at the end of the introductory paragraph ينطي رأيه at the end of the introductory paragraph educators debate educators argue طبعا debate هي نفسها noun ونفسها شنو نفسها verb okay educators debate whether the separation of boys and girls into single sex classes might improve طبعا هنا استخدم might حتى يعني لا يكون جدا قاطع في رأيه might هذا استخدام جيد ان شاء الله بعدين نشرح هذه الـ يسموها الـ hedges or meta discourse items في ان شاء الله محاضرات لاحقة نشرحها might improve students academic performance اذا ظهر على الساحة الان مفهوم جديد ومفهوم يريد يناقش الكاتب اللي هو الـ academic performance يعني does it affect the active does it affect the sorry the what the academic performance or not this separation Does it affect it? If it affects it, does it affect it positively or negatively? يعني أولا, does the separation of boys and girls affect their academic performance? وأكاديميك performance يعني شنو نقصد به؟ الأكاديميك achievement, الأكاديميك accomplishment. Okay? الأكاديميك success. نجاحهم الأكاديمي, هل ال separation يعني we separate boys into يعني boys classes and girls into girls classes, يعني ما نخليهم شنو ما نخليهم together, فهل هو هذا separation مفيد to the academic performance لو لا, هل هو مفيد لو لا؟ هنا هو أثار التساؤل عندك, انت راح تقول صحيح هل هو مفيد ام غير مفيد. I don't know. So what is the writer's opinion about this? إذن هنا stimulates something in us as readers. He stimulates what? He stimulates our thinking about the topic. يعني هو هنا involving us, engaging us as readers into this idea, triggering our thinking. يعني هنا هو سوى شنو stimulation to our, شوف قلت أنا سوى stimulation, استخدمتها كنون, بينما مساح شنو قلت does he stimulate or he wants to stimulate, استخدمتها كverb, our thinking about the topic. هنا يعني the writer wants us to be involved in the what, in this particular discussion, argument, debate. بعدين ننتقل إلى جملة. طبعا هذه الجملة يعني قد تكون جملة as an additional information. Single-sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago. طبعا single-sex classes ما كانوا موافقين عليه. في الفترة السابقة في القانون كان single sex classes ممنوع, يعني كانوا مثلا at this particular age, at this tough years, at this middle school years, كانوا دائما يعني the same mixed sex classes, يعني يدمج الboys والgirls في السادس ابتدائي, الأول متوسط, ثاني متوسط, ثالث متوسط, أو أول متوسط سوري والثاني متوسط, يعني في يعني نهاية البرايمري بداية السكندري سكول, يعني كان في القانون ممنوع تفصلهم, مو single sex classes were against yes ممنوع تفصلهم, were against the law in public schools, في المدارس الحكومية, okay, المدارس العامة الحكومية, until several years ago, لكن recently طبعا هاي نتيجة شنو؟ نتيجة البحوث المكتوبة في هذا الموضوع. يعني وصلوا إلى مثلا بعض الدراسات وصلت إلى أنه the separation is better than the putting in what? In same single classes or single class or same sex classes, sorry. Either in same sex classes or in single sex classes. يعني توصلوا إلى أنه وضعهم في نفس الصف, يعني البويز والجيرلز قد يسبب بعض الإشكالات, والسيبريشن يعني ذا سيبريشن يسبب بعض النجاحات. طبعا هذا شنو؟ هذا لحد الآن هو شنو؟ جاي يناقش الآراء, different points of view, راح جاي يناقش الدبيت, جاي يناقش الأرجيومنت, بعدنا ما واصلين إلى رأي الكاتب. فش قال؟ قال single sex classes were against the law in public schools until several years ago, but now they have become more common. وهذه معلومة تحتاج إلى مصدر. معلومة تحتاج إلى مصدر. فلذلك هو استخدم هذا المصدر between two brackets, Bonner and Hollingsworth. إن شاء الله عندما تدرسون البحث راح تتعلمون citation, how to cite others' ideas, يعني other writers' ideas. Okay, how to integrate and cite, يعني دخل ال outside sources you take the information from into our into your what into your argument into your debate into your discussion into your text. لأن أنت بتاخذ المعلومة من مصدر آخر حتى لا ترتكب plagiarism انتحال علمي سرقة علمية وحتى توثق المعلومة تقول أنا خذيتها من هذا المصدر حتى تنطي فد authority للمعلومة مالتك حتى تنطي authority للمعلوماتك تقول يا بترى أنا يعني ما جبت هذه المعلومة من فراغ يعني it's not only my opinion لا it's taken from research other research taken from articles taken from books taken from this specific source حتى تتجنب شنو تتجنب البلاجيرزم السرقة العلمية أو الانتحال العلمي فخذها من هذا المصدر وإذا يعني تحب تشاهد يعني سلسلة المحاضرات اللي انطيتها للمرحلة الثالثة العام الماضي أوكي 36 محاضرة تقدر تشوفها على الويب سايت فيما يتعلق بكتابة البحث محاضرات جدا مهمة بين تلك المحاضرات يعني إذا تشاهد هذه المحاضرات راح تفهم الكثير من الأمور اللي تتعلق بالبحث يعني مثلا citation, writing abstracts, introduction, etc. The uses of why do we write, for example, why do we write a research paper, how to avoid plagiarism, how to do summary and paraphrase, etc. And quotation وإلى آخره محاضرات موجودة على الويب سايت زين وكذلك عندكم إن شاء الله يعني عندكم درسونا هذا الموضوع في المرحلة الثالثة نأتي إلى الجملة الأهم في الأساي كله مو فقط في الانتروداكتوري باراجراف Now the last sentence is very much important We are moving from the very wide or the wider into the very specific. Yeah, moving from here to a very specific what? Very specific idea about what? About the topic. About the topic. الآن هو اجت مرحلة إعطاء الرأي مو تقول أكو debate أكو argument whether the separation is good or bad for academic performance أنت شنو رأيك أيها الكاتب what is your opinion what is your position what is your claim you are going to what you are going to defend in the body paragraphs you are going to support in the body paragraphs. You are going to give evidence for your opinion in the body paragraphs. هذه الجملة هي الجملة الأهم في ال, يعني in the whole essay, not only in the introductory paragraph, in the whole essay. Although some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups, even, انطان هنا الشرائح من المجتمع parents اكو some parents some educators and some what civil liberties groups continue to oppose يعني هذه الفئات مو كل الفئات لا قال some هذه كلمة some جدا مهمة دائما لا تعمم رأيك لا تعمم الرأي قال although some parents, educators, and civil liberties groups continue to oppose, continue to disagree with. To oppose means to disagree with. Single-sex classes. يعني against what? They are against what? من يجاوبني?
Separation of boys and girls.
Excellent. Excellent. They are against, they are opposing, they disagree with the idea of separating. The idea of separating. ما قلت the idea. Yeah, the idea of separation. تصير. لكن the idea of separating something. لازم استخدم ing هنا. They are against the idea of putting boys and girls separately, putting them away.
عفوا دكتور.
نعم.
دكتور عفوا منك بس دكتور أحمد ما أنا سوى دعوة يعني بس منتظرين
ندخل. أوكي إن شاء الله خلصت أنا. المفروض محاضرتكم تبدي بالعشرة ونص. يعني محاضرة
أوكي
أوكي حسب لا أنا خلصت فقط هذه الجملة حتى تكون المحاضرة تامة يعني فقط هذه الجملة وننتهي. إذن although some parents, educators and civil liberties groups continue to oppose, continue to disagree with single sex classes, but my opinion as a writer is something different. قال there is some evidence يعني ما جاب رأيه من فراغ. There is some evidence taken from sources, taken from articles, taken from other books, taken from articles and journals. يعني مأخوذة من مصادر موثوقة. There is some evidence that separating boys and girls in middle school produces positive results. This is the main idea of the whole essay presented in the thesis sentence at the end of the introductory paragraph. هذه الكور ايديا الكور سنتنس the focal sentence of all of what among all the other sentences mentioned in the essay. والى هنا ان شاء الله ننتهي في تحليل هذا الجزء من الاسي وننتقل ان شاء الله للمحاضره المقبله إلى تحليل thesis sentence on page 83 وعدكم امتحان يا طلاب في exercise number 3 اللي هو practice number 3 وexercise number 5 امتحان شفهي يعني
which page dot
pages 82 83 84 يعني من 82 إلى 84 امتحان شفهي أجي يعني أسجل حضور وغياب الغائب يأخذ صفر الغائب يأخذ صفر هاي أولا أسجل الحضور والغياب يأخذ صفر واللي يتأخر بالحضور ما يعني ما أسمح له بالدخول أسألك سؤال مثلا أقول لك يعني حلي البراك يعني مثلا on page 84 أقول لك مثلا الجملة نمبر 3 كمل لي إياها يعني على حساب أنه أنت فاهم شنو فاهم الثيسيس ستيتمنت شلون تكمل لي إياها وهكذا وأريد أجوبة مختلفة الـ identical answers ما أقبلها يعني الطلاب متفقين على نفس الجواب ما أقبله وإن شاء الله نشوفكم بالخير الأسبوع المقبل وأنا آسف جدا طولت عليكم في هذا الشرح شوي المعمق اللي يخص الـ introductory paragraph لكن هذا يبقى عندك يعني تستفيد من عنده إلى بقية الدروس والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أرجو المغادرة إن لم يكن لديكم أي سؤال
No, sir. Thank you so much for this valuable information. Really, really, it's really amazing.
Most welcome. Thank you very much. Most welcome. Okay. طلاب أرجو المغادرة سريعا رجاءً.